Hi, my name is Deepak and I'm an entrepreneur. I want to know how many of you are actually entrepreneurs or if anybody other started something their own, anything like that. Is there anyone want to start their own? Okay, great. So there are some kind of audience which are super good. Okay, so I'm the co-founder and CEO of Innoz and I am here to talk about my story. I started this company from my college dorm room and we have millions of customers all over the world. Okay. Starting up in 2008, I was doing my computer science graduation at Lal Bahadur Shastri College in Kasargod. LBS has been known for just for the spikes and hurtas, that's what happening over there. So we had a lot of time to do something around being backbenchers. I had three of my co-founders from the same batch who were passionate about doing something our own rather than joining the rat race. So media picked up first, we were supported by Technopark. They picked up, they incubated us. So incubation is a part of program by which companies are matured when they are starting up. So we were officially the first virtual incubated company in India on 2008. That means we work from the college. We have a physical address back in Technopark 200. The idea all about was that we have a good branding when we started out. After graduating my computer science, I do have some papers still left. I went to this program called iAccelerator that was in IMA. We were among the 8 companies selected from India who were nurtured with seed funding. So that seed funding, I will come to the point later, funding is obviously required to start something our own, okay? Other than what we have from our family and all. So when we started up, none of us come from any business background. I'm just a middle class. I'm born and brought up in the Thrissur district. So that's the story when we started out. Okay, next slide. So how we tackle the great problem? So any company right now becoming successful originates with an idea. So what an idea is actually, it's a consumer's facing problem. That's an idea about. So how we tackle the problem? So we found out that more than 60% in India doesn't have the connectivity for the internet. Right now we all have the internet, we know how to take the internet, we know how to browse the internet and all. But still, at least 60% in India doesn't know how to get information at a particular time. So that was the problem that we faced or what we tried to solve. Everybody, irrespective of the age and loss and location, have some questions to ask, and not anybody has the right way to get an information on demand. So how this idea actually originated? One of my co-founders who was on the move on a train want to get some information on his dumb phone, a normal phone, which doesn't have any internet connectivity. Thought this is a consumer facing problem which can really take the masses to empower them. So we invented SMSGyan. As the name suggests, Gyan means knowledge in Hindi. It's an instant cup of knowledge. You will get any information that you would like to know about at a particular time at an information through an SMS medium, which is any phone can use it. So how it works, it's just there's a short code, 5544. How many of here have Airtel mobile, Airtel Tata Docomo? Anyone can use the service actually. You can send any questions on demand, who invented Abacus, which is the tallest tower, what is the population of Kerala, any question that you would like to know about, you can send to the short code and you will get instant information on demand. So what we done is that we bridged basically the internet players Wikipedia, internet resources. So what basically Google do on the internet is what we are doing on mobile. So internet, if you know how Google works, it's just all the data from a list of content and arrange in such a way that people can easily find that. So what we did here is that instead of just the differentiating point between Google and SMSGyan is the fact that in mobile people care about time and money, right? I mean, we don't have such a lot of time to take Google and get the results. Like, you know, if you send a query like which is the tallest tower, you'll get a list of results. You need to click on that and go to the correct data. In the PCs you have the time, but in mobile you don't have the time. So what we did is that we built a context flow in which Gyan actually act as an answer engine. Suppose if you are asking a particular question, you will definitely get an answer in response. So that may care for your time and money. So the USP is that it actually affords a consumer learning mechanism. It's like an m-learning solution where any people can actually learn about new topics each day. So end of the day, we are making people learn something every day. So there are X number of services right now integrated, like, you know, as I just mentioned to you about Wikipedia and other information engines, we do have movie reviews, book reviews, weather information, stock market, all the things, anything under an umbrella, that's what we are trying to do on the internet, on the mobile. So this is actually a live demo, like, you ask something, you ask for Katrina case, you will get the details about who the person is, you can actually read more. So on the first response, we support up to maximum 480 characters. That would be charged at a price point of 1 rupees. That's quite nominal for any customer who can actually use it, and also a subscription format by which customer can subscribe at a rupee. And you can actually, it's not just an SMS search engine, it's actually an answer engine together with a content delivery platform. So basically, if you are trying for a query, you will have the option to download the photos and videos also, clicking on the link, downloading the content. So it's effectively acting as a very useful case for any customer, not just a normal phone user. So basic technology is like we just built the content players in a platform which is open and also on the cloud. So we have the list of players on the internet space. We just integrate through the gateways that the telecom operator is providing. Telecom operator means the Airtel and all the operators. We bridge with them, we give the data, we provide to the customer on the back end, all in a 1 second or two. That's the total time taken. So these are some of our loyal customers. YouTube, widely SMSGyan as a product to, you know, there are quite number of decent queries happening, like how to improve the security, something like that. These are most trending happening. I'll show you that example. Like, students use actively for the BSC exams, like if you want to know about a particular thing, you can instantly use it on SMSGyan. Villagers use effectively for finding the mandi rates, like about the crop prices and all weather information. Next slide. So we commercially launched this product on January 2011. That was in Bharati Airtel. Right now we are running inside most of the telecom operators. And the vision is by 2012 end, we would be live inside all operators with the same short code. So basically it would be a Google on mobile. Anything you would like to know about a particular time would be answered by our site. And it is improving each day. We have right now a user base of 2 million customers pan-India, and the plan is to emerge into other emerging markets, like especially those places where the internet connectivity is quite low. The fact is that, you know, the reason that Google can't, Google still faces a problem is the internet penetration in countries like in India, and where our real potential is. So we actually profile the customers. These are actually the top queries happening. Like, obviously, in India, ABCD rules the market. Astrology, Bollywood, cricket, and devotional. These are the things really happening in India. But other than that, we are actually seeing some kind of traction. And the fact is that we are making people learn something new every day. And we are the first in the kind of business right now. USPs are what makes our product a success right now. One is that it's available to the whole market in India and across the world. It's an SMS driven product. It's plug and play, nothing to install. Any customer can actually use it. It's live across millions of customers, and every second actually hundreds of people are beyond. So that's the USP that we have. Next slide. Some decent feedback from the customers, even on the urban metros who are actually on the GPRS segment. We actually are effectively using the same product as in rural Indian market, like, you know, we implemented kind of solutions like English tutor on SMS, which actually helps the rural customer to learn a word a day. So it's basically an e-learning solution. Next. So user flagging, as you all know, Google wasn't built in a day, right? It takes time for us to build the best and better search engine. We are trying to improve each day. We are actually having a team of 12 members in, so I'll talk about the team later. So we have an R&D team who are actually doing the customer feedback, like improving the product each day. So the vision is, like, you know, we can't compete with Google. Google is the largest player on the internet, right? On the online world, Google is the largest search. But still there are enough potential that people have or want to know in an offline world, like my customers right now, my mom actually sitting at my home. She don't know how to use the internet, but she can use the SMSGyan. There are customers who are actually using the internet as well as using the SMSGyan platform. The fact is that we right now downloaded more than 35 gigabytes of information over SMS channel since the launch. So that means, like, you know, and most of them don't know how to access the internet. So that's the great potential that we are seeing. So I just mentioned that we are live inside all the telecom operators. So there are multiple ways of making revenue as a company perspective. So we started in 2009, and by 2015, the vision is to be a 100 crore turnover company in terms of revenue. That's from operator loop and also from cross-selling the products inside. Right now, Innoz is one of the most exciting and talked about startups, in the sense, like, you know, it's quite new in India that people are starting from the college room. I mean, in the valley, you can see, like, Mark Zuckerberg, lot of inspiring people who want to change the world. Doesn't want to, you know, take the rat race, like, you know, join some companies and work for them like 24/7. So they want to really, they had something. These were the things that inspired us in the beginning. Like the inspiration that we got, like, you know, why can't the, like, you know, people in the valleys, like in the early 20s, making some Fortune 500 companies? Why don't we do the same in India? So that was the inspiration, and that was the real act of starting our own. We were recognized as the top 100 companies in the world right now. We have the presence in US market. We are among the Nasscom rated companies. So Nasscom is an association in India for the enterprises. So they are rated among the top emerging companies in India. We won the MIT TR35 this year, 2011. Some people are actually our mentors and also very supportive from the day one we started. Like, for example, this globalization sir, who is one of my mentors. And the other is Asidhar, who is one of my mentors at Technopark. There are people who invested us without seeing us. Like, you know, in real, like, you know, when we were part of an accelerator program. Sadhish Dharmaj was actually an investor at Yahoo when they started us. And so he also part of our investment team. So this is a slide, like, you know, we actually celebrated our third anniversary on 15th of September. And this is how we celebrated, like, in a CSR mode. Like, you know, we celebrated with around 400 students who are actually not so we celebrated with them having a lunch and onan sadhya and with some sweets and all. So that's like the all idea of showing this slide is that we are not just doing a business. So the lessons learned, it's good to start young. Right now, like, you know, we don't have any other commitments. We can, like, you know, straightly look on the business and do the things right now. We are chasing big dreams with no commitments, and people care more. That's the most important point. When we started up, the media picked up well. That brings up our exposure to the real world. We didn't have the support at first phase, again from the family, like they weren't aware about what actually we are looking for or going about. But thanks to the media, thanks to the people who supported, like, about the branding from Technopark and Amir, were really helpful when we started up. we found that the main problem of starting up was not just, it's not a one-man army. Like right now, you can't make a company grow big with a one-member person. It's not about the innovation, it's about the team. There's a great quote by Mr. Vinod Khosla saying that the company you build is the team you build. So that's the way it about me. I was lucky that I'm standing right now in front of you because of my team working 24/7 at the offices. So it's all about the team, the core strength lies in the team. Take external sources of funds only when necessary. When you start up, you really could require an angel round. That is 3 F's that we say, friends, family and fools that invest inside your company when you start up. Other than that, no one will invest. So that's the real investment that you should really look on it. And once you are actually in a market that you figured that the business and this is the way it is projected for the next couple of years, then only you think about taking an external sources of funding. I raised my first outside funding when I had some potential customers right now. And this happened only in the last few months. So till now, I was actually funded from the funds that I received from the clients, which are my biggest investors. And these were the words when one of my mentors told me about while starting up. Partner with the best, big corporates like Bharti Airtel, Tata Docomo and all others, the main advantage, I mean for example Vodafone also, the main advantage of partnering with big clients is that, you know, they bring more into a corporate culture into the company. It's not an easy way to do a startup in India, like especially in a country like in India. You need to really show some talent and attitude towards the company, and then only they will respect and partner us alongside. So that's the strategy you should take. You should try to partner with bigger clients while starting up. And the last point, but not the least, entrepreneurship is not a class or not a study subject. It can't be taught. The best way to do it is just do it. Nothing else can stop you from doing that. And end of the day, who is your biggest inspiration? It's your dream. Nothing can, you know, take it from there. You should have a dream to be large and become successful unless nobody else can help you out.